My name is Ewa Mrukwa-Kominek. I come from Poland. I am head of the university of the ophthalmology department in the university hospital. This is the University of Silesia, Medical University of Silesia, is in Katowice in south of Poland. Our experience with Activa Trinova are now lasted now more than 1 year, but I would like to show you our first statistical results. So, as we know that the proper lens choice is very important to reach the excellent effect after cataract surgery. So if we choose the right lens, we can give the patients perfect vision. We can ask if really the revolution of trifocal IOL bring the new Activa Trinova. These sharp edges and pointy peaks of the overlapping patterns of the traditional trifocal IOL are the main cause of the positive dysphotopsia. So Activa Trinova has smoothly varying surface profile that helps to reduce halos, glare, due to the reduced scattered of light. Activa Trinova is manufactured with sinusoidal vision technology. This is unique diffraction pattern derived from sinusoidal functions to produce an IOL optical surface, which does not exhibit any sharp edges. We can find it 12 unique ridges created in highest light transmission and optimum light distribution through the all optical diameter. That gives us the better contrast sensitivity, dynamic visual performance, and as well as reduce the halos and glare. Aspheric optic and the chromatic aberrations free structure is leading to enhanced depth of focus and provide continuous vision enhanced spectacle independence at all distances. Based on this how now, the VSI biotechnology improved the edge of optic design and introduced the sinusoidal vision technology. As you know, contrast sensitivity is much better in the sinusoidal lens, Activa Trinova, especially in mesopic condition in comparison to the other trifocal lenses that you can have on the market. Activa Trinova gives us the possibility that 92% of effective light transmission go to the retina. Excellent modulation transfer function at all distances. That's mean that the ability of an optical system is to transfer contrast from the object to the image as a function of spatial frequencies. You can see here the peak. So the range of the vision is 42 centimeters. It's much... the range is better than in other trifocal lenses. So the greater performance of total focus area is from the far to near. This wide depth, widest depth of focus and outstanding visual outcomes, even as mesopic condition. This is also interesting that Activa Trinova has the highest tolerance to decentration and the angle kappa with its central diameter of 1.4 millimeters. The angle kappa may play a very important role for a successful premium IOL implantation. If the lens is significantly decentered because of failure to accommodate for angle kappa, then central light rays may miss the central optical zone and pass through the one of the multifocal rings, leading to glare. In this case, the size of the central ring plays an important role. An IOL with a wide central ring may tolerate angle kappa much more than the IOL with a small central ring. Our results, our analysis was to evaluate the clinical outcomes of this trifocal IOL, sinusoidal trifocal IOL Activa Trinova. For this analysis, we included 20 eyes with was implanted with this lens, 5 men and 7 women. The mean power of the IOL was between 17 and 23 diopters. This was also always this was the surgery was standard phaco emulsification with the IOL implantation in remaining lens capsule. You can see that the implantation goes very smooth. The lens opened very carefully, but have no necessity to different maneuver into the eye. And you can see that the range of the vision of these rings are very deep. Here you can see the visual acuity changes, the best corrected distance and uncorrected distance visual acuity. In decimal scale, you can notice that you can see that the mean best corrected distance visual acuity is the same that the uncorrected, so there was no need for correction, and improved after 12 weeks in comparison to before the surgery. The best corrected and uncorrected near visual acuity, this is in Snellen scale, so the lowest, the best. You can see that the mean is 0.5, this is the best near visual acuity. So the difference between post and to the preoperative is statistically significant. So the intermediate visual acuity is very good and improved in the postoperative time. So 12 weeks after surgery in the Jaeger scale is the mean is 2. In the significant majority of patients, the maximum visual acuity was reached for near and for intermediate, so for all distances. No refractive surprise was noticed, no dislocation of the IOL were observed, and statistical spherical error ranged before -1 to +7.5, so the range was large, but after surgery was between -0.25 to +0.75. So we use the right formula for calculation of this. Then we can also notice here that the don't change the cylindrical power, because it was not cylindrical lens, but the cylinder didn't change after the surgery. We also checked the patients with a VFI-14 patient satisfaction questionnaire. You can see here that this is a brief questionnaire designed to measure functional impairment of patients due to the cataract. It consists of 14 to 18 questions covering 14 aspects of visual function affected by cataracts. And the visual function shows higher internal consistency and is a reliable, valid instrument to provide us information not conveyed but visual acuity or general health structure measures. So we noticed that the mean VFI the scale was in points. You can see here that the before surgery was 59 points, mean points, and after is 86.7. We should notice that nobody, no young, healthy patient reach 100, but the maximum is 100. So 86 is very good results in comparison on other trifocal lenses. This was the visual function questionnaire, and the contrast sensitivity. This is also very interesting that with this special kind of lens, the contrast sensitivity, the spatial frequency or cycles per degree in the day and in the night conditions are very good. You can see here this scale, and as less as the best. So we have no change. We didn't notice significant differences of the density of corneal endothelial cells before and after surgery, as well as no IOP rays was noticed. So in summary, we can conclude that the sinusoidal vision technology trifocal IOL Acriva Trinova give us the highest light transmission, superior optical performance, is comfortable reading, give comfortable reading distances, balanced light distribution, excellent post-op stability, is easy to implant, give us greater patient satisfaction. In our short observation group, we don't notice no refractive surprise, and we don't observe no refractive surprise. Post-operative refractive error is small and not statistically significant. And in this observation time, the refractive error seems to be stable. Now we have observation of this patient, some of the patient more than 1 year, and this is really stable. And the lens gives patients more satisfaction. Thank you for your attention.